Hello, I'm Ash, and today I thought I'd share a quick demo and review on my MAC lipsticks. These include some pink, nude, natural, bold, and classic shades. So for each lipstick, I'm also going to be applying a lip prep and primer to help moisturize my lips. We're going to get started with Angel, and it looks like a pale pink with my skin tone. It's also supposed to have this frost finish, but because it's such a light color, it looks very pearly instead. Now, High Strung has a real frost finish. It has a nice deep pink shade, but there's a lot of silver, which makes it gleam and dazzle, which was cool in the late 90s with a little bit of liner, but today it's just too overwhelming. So Syrup is more like my kind of pink. It's got a little bit of blue undertone, which helps to make the pink complement my skin tone. The luster finish also feels very creamy and has a beautiful semi-gloss look. Blankety is another light pink shade, but it's got some beige, which makes it perfect as a nude lipstick. I use this lipstick every day, and I think it's perfect when paired with a heavy or dark eyeshadow. This next one is High Tea. It's a beige shade with a little bit of pink. It also has a luster finish, which looks very glossy, so if you like having plump or juicy lips, you should try out this shade. Now, Viva Glam 2 is a pale and muted pink mauve color. It is a semi-matte finish. I think it's the best Viva Glam shade ever, and 100% of its profit also supports the MAC AIDS Fund, which I love. This is Enchanted One. It's from the Alluring Aquatic Collection of 2014, and it's a limited edition shade. It's also a peachy coral color with a very matte finish. Next is Velvet Teddy. It's another matte finish, and it's described as a deep tone beige, but I think it looks more like a rosy brown. This is also a must-have shade for 2015. Now Mehr is a dirty blue pink with a matte finish. It also looks really similar to my natural lip color, so I've been wearing it a lot this summer. Overall, this is a great modest and subtle color. Now, Amorous is a shade that I underestimated. It was a whim that I picked it up, and it turned out to be a light cranberry shade that is just so flattering on my skin tone. I should have probably used it with a lip liner, but I do have some brushes. Overall, this is a great color to start for fall, and I hope it gets more noticed now. Styled in Sepia is from the 2014 Matte Lip Collection, which is a limited edition shade. It is a very somber, dirty cement beige color, which is perfect for cool toned skin or hair color. This next color is perfect for the winter, but it's dark, so it'll need a lip liner. It's also a matte lipstick with a very dry and thick formula, so make sure to use a lip primer to help make it easier during the application. This shade is also described as a deep, dark blue-red shade, and to me it feels very retro and also mysterious, and it's called Sin. Goddess of the Sea is limited edition. It is supposed to be a dark, vibrant violet shade, but because it has this cream sheen finish, it is very sheer and just looks like a reddish violet shade. Now, Heroine is more vibrant. It's an electric shade that's very wearable in all skin tones. It's also a matte lipstick, which means it's highly pigmented, so I'm being very careful on how I apply it since I'm not using a lip liner. You can also use a blip brush, but add some concealer around your lipstick to prevent it from feathering. And this is pretty much Heroine. It's probably one of the most stunning and unexpected lipsticks that I've ever fallen in love with. Finally, I have two red lipsticks left, and I've lined my lips for them. This first one is Ruby Woo. It has a retro matte formula, which looks very flat, but can also feel very dry. It is the most classic and universal red shade. It is highly pigmented, and it has the longest wearing formula. I love this lipstick, and I always feel empowered when wearing it. So this is Russian Red. It has a matte formula, which feels creamier and easier to apply, but I did notice that it's not completely matte. It has a little bit of shine to the finish, so I'd say it's more of a semi-matte red lipstick. Overall, these two shades look identical. They both have blue undertones, but Ruby Woo is a brighter matte red, and Russian Red is a deeper semi-matte red. Well, that's all of the MAC lipsticks that I could share with you guys today. These are my top 5 lipsticks that I think you should at least try out or purchase. Thanks again for watching today's video, and please let me know in the description box which color you liked on me or what you'd get for yourself.